So, I mean, just talk a little bit about, start with what you saw from Sullivan today. I mean, it's obviously you said he was getting a nod in the starting lineup earlier in the week, but having him come out there and have a dominant performance and then finish it off with 6 points towards the team score over a quality ranked opponent, is that something you saw coming, or how much did that help you out there today against a quality ranked team?
That was huge, and I was happy for Ryan. He's put in a lot of work, and he came back kind of heavy, and he's worked at getting his weight down, and not only got his weight down, but he looks good, and he looks sharp. And he did a really nice job today. The kid was hurting. We could see he was hurting, and he smelled the blood and went out and got a fall. So, he did a great job. I'm happy for him.
And then it looks like, obviously, too, for Noah, that this was his, most dominant and definitely offensive laden performance of the season. What do you think he had? I mean, he's been solid all year, but this is obviously the most offensive we've seen him. What was going well for him out there today?
I don't know, but if you figure it out, let me know. He looked good. Yeah, I think he was dominant, and that's what we were trying to get him to do is use all of his weapons. And he was shooting, he was attacking the legs, he was using an underhook. He looked good.
And then obviously also for the second or third match this year, we've seen the heavyweight go out there and show his ability to shoot and get to his offense. I mean, how much is that gonna help you later on in the year as you get into some close matches where you can actually count on a heavyweight to go out there, capitalize on some shots, which you don't always see?
Yeah, well, I think whenever you have another solid guy in the lineup, it's good for your team. But it's good. The more Michael can shoot and get into positions, then we can help fix his wrestling. If he or anyone goes out and stands around, it's hard for us to help, fix things. And he's out scrapping, and he looked pretty good today. So, we were happy with his performance.
And also talking a little bit about Killian, what have you seen change in him and his performance over these last two matches in particular, to where he's really been able to get to his offense and get some quality wins, probably his best two of the season thus far?
I think he feels better. Got a couple matches under his belt. Remember, these kids haven't wrestled. They hadn't wrestled for months and months and months. It was a long layoff, and he just looks more comfortable. Physically looks good. So yeah, and his offense is clicking a little better. So we're hoping he can keep building on that.
And then talk a little bit about too about what you saw from Peyton today. I mean, there were a couple instances in the match where he might have put himself in a little bit more of a difficult position, but he did prove throughout the match to be able to sort of get himself out of something and come back and end up getting the big win to finish off the meet in good fashion.
Yeah, he got out of some positions, but he didn't need to be in those. I think you hit the nail on the head. Listen, he's a good wrestler. I don't think that was his best performance. I don't think he felt great. I don't know if it was, they picked a weight class, and obviously he was the last of the duel, and
Right.
that's not normal for him. But he's wrestled his whole life. He's probably a little better warm up. But we'll see better days from Peyton. But it's always nice to get a win when you're not at your best. It really says that, hey, it's a pretty solid wrestler.
And what are you looking? I mean, looking ahead, you guys have a bit of a tough stretch coming up where you're going to be traveling a lot. You're going to have some matches that are happening later in the evening. I mean, what's going to be key to sort of, we spoke about this last week, that the season's a grind and you're kind of getting into the meat of that grind coming up. So what's going to be key moving forward to, handle these things in stride and keep adding some conference wins?
I just told the team we just got finished up our team meeting, and I think you just stay even keeled. If you had a big win, say Ryan Sullivan, he can't go out and eat three dinners because, oh, I did great. And you're never as good as you think you are. You're never as bad as you think you are. Just we always talk to him about putting your hard hat on and going back to work tomorrow. just doing the right things. I think the more times you do the right things during the season, you're going to be okay at the end.
And then so the last question I have for you is, obviously you had a solid match pretty much all the way around today, but you know, there's always things to improve upon. So looking forward, what are those things that moving forward, do you want to make any adjustments, or what are some things that you know, want to keep seeing out of your guys, or any improvements that you want to make moving forward and finishing the season off strong?
Yeah, I think generally there's always things, and individually there's certainly things that each kid has to work on. But, you know, just I think it's like any sport, and I think you talk to a coach in football, basketball, whatever, basics, you know, always come back. You know, if we can protect our legs and, you know, and finish periods off strong and all those little things, we'll be pretty good. But we have some guys, I think, you know, Scotty Joel, if he just sticks to the basics, he's a real tough dude, you know, and he just let that guy get in on his legs a little bit. So situations like that, those basics will really show up, you know, at the end of the season.
And then I guess my final question for you. So what do you need to do? And you kind of touched upon it a little bit there to maybe in matches where your guy might be a little bit outmatched, what do you need to do to try to secure a decision as opposed to, you know, a major decision for the other team? Because obviously in a closer duel, those can be costly.
Yeah, you have to, I mean, yes, you have to keep the matches tighter. You know, sometimes you go out with a little bit of strategy. You know, if I'm really outmatched, I can't go out just flailing around. I'm going to get thrown down and you know, pinned or scored on. We've got to do a better job of keeping those matches tight so that we can maybe win and use our conditioning to, you know, win in the third period or in overtime.
And moving forward, do you think that this is the lineup that you'll be sticking with into the postseason, or is that just always a potential adjustments if needed, or depending on what happens in that practice room next week?
Yeah, we'll probably bring a guy or two to at some different weights to the Cowboy Challenge in 2 weeks, get him some matches. I mean, I like what I saw out of these guys. You know, obviously our 84s are pretty similar, but Jackson, you know, won the wrestle off, so he's in there for now. I thought Ryan Sullivan did a nice job today, so, you know, we liked what we saw. But yeah, for the most part, I think this is our lineup, but it's like you just don't know with this COVID. Yeah. And I mean, it's a tough enough sport without a virus running around. So it's like you're going to drop guys for, you know, hey, I got a hurt ankle or knee, or I'm out this week, my ribs hurt. And now you got this COVID. So we're just every day when the phone rings, I'm just like, oh no. So I think it looks like this is, you know, this lineup is for the most part intact.